Welcome back. Welcome here. Welcome for the first time, the second time, the last time. Not for, I mean, I'll keep doing these, but you may stop watching after this one. Who knows? I don't know. Well, this is going to be a live stream, English learning live stream. So English learners, English lovers, welcome. We're going to be doing some interesting stuff. I'll be talking to a friend, doing an interview, and also, as usual, doing the classic Q&A that we always do. So make sure you have your questions ready. Get your questions ready in your mind, write them down, think about things you've been working on, and ask them. And I'll do my best to answer questions. I was having some technical troubles before today's stream, so I was running around like a crazy man. And now I have a second to just take a sip of coffee and balance myself. Calm down. Guys, if you haven't already, don't forget to also hit the like button here at the start. Subscribe, that's very important. And if you want to improve your English, check out my full courses in the links in the description. I've got 11 courses up there right now. Maybe by the time you're watching this, more, because I'm launching a bunch of new ones pretty soon. Thanks for hitting the like button. Much appreciated. All right, let me just quickly update. Hey, Freddy Krueger's here. That's scary. Let me update the cover, and then we'll get started. Okay. Cover updated. So. Good. Good, good, good. All right. Yeah, you got to have a sip of coffee first, Mohammed. That's how you stay balanced. It's the only way for me to do it. Works for me every time. Okay, and I've got my can't believe everything actually came together today. It's been an insane day. Let me pop my headphones on here. As you may have heard me talk about many times on this channel, perhaps the most important part of actually learning to use the language naturally and understand the language well is not so much the words, not so much the phrases, not so much the grammar, but is an understanding references, cultural references, the things that native English speakers know that often you may not know because you didn't grow up in a native English speaking country. So, I'm going to be talking to my friend Pablo, who I think has some really good insights on this. And I'm going to bring him in, and we're going to do sort of an interview. So, I hope you enjoy it. Let me send Pablo the link and bring him in. One sec. Where's Pablo? There's Pablo. Okay, I'm going to bring him in. Guys, get your questions ready as well. Ask your questions. Prepare questions for me. Pablo may answer questions. Who knows if he wants to, depending on how busy he is. But he's agreed to talk to me for a few minutes. His precious, precious time. I had to pay him $100,000 to do this. Let's see if he comes on. Meg is here. Hello, Meg. Only human. Hi, what's up? Only human. Well, human, nothing wrong with being a human. There he is.
Hi, Luke.
Hey, Pablo. How's it going? Could you center yourself a little bit more, like in the? Do you see me on the side? Oh, your light's pretty good, actually. You got good lighting setup.
I don't know.
But no worries.
It is inverted. I moved.
Oh, I see. It's inverted.
Inverted.
That's fine.
Okay, it's better.
I wouldn't say that, but okay. Well, actually, now I can't see your ear. I think you have to move to your left, maybe move your chair to, like, scoot over a little bit to your left or right. Because now I only see half of your face. Now I only see you, like, you're like this.
Okay. Oh. And now?
Now we're looking good. Now we're looking real good.
Okay, fine.
Fantastic. How are you doing?
Very good. Very good.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for doing this. I appreciate it.
Thank you. It's amazing because it's very strange. Because I never speak in English with anyone, and now I'm doing it live on YouTube live.
Brave soul.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's one of the things I wanted to ask you about. So just a little background information. I know you, Pablo, because we're in the same chat group. And one thing I've always noticed is more than anyone else, if I make a weird reference to something that I don't think anyone will know, you always know it. You're the only one who knows who understands most of the things that I say. So as my question is, so number one is, why do you understand those things? Because English is not your first language, right? So how did you get to a place where you're able to, not on the surface level, understand the deeper level of memes and, you know, references that only native speakers really tend to know?
I think, I'm getting silenced to the notification.
No, turn them all up. I want to hear all of them.
Okay.
And you can reply to all of them. We'll just sit in silence and you can reply to each one as they come in. That'll be great.
Okay. I think it's because, first of all, I am very curious. And I like to Google all the things and enter to Wikipedia. Besides that, I think in Argentina, in Buenos Aires, most of all, we have a culture very globalized, and we feel like we are part of the Western culture. I don't know if in the United States is the same way, but in Europe, I know that they think that we are South Americans, but we are not part of Western culture. And
really?
To the people here, that is strange. But it, I don't know if it is okay, because I think it would be better if we think ourselves as South Americans and not part of Western culture, because in the other parts of our continent, the Spanish speakers of America, like in Brazil or in the Caribbean, they think they aren't part of Western culture, I think, more than here in Buenos Aires. But we have a lot of influence because of the, how do you say, the immigration from Europe.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm white. I have white skin, and my grandfathers were from Europe, and that's because we think that we are the same culture. And I learned all of those things in Spanish, but are the same cultural reference.
Same cultural backgrounds. Okay? That's interesting. Yeah. Well, I can't speak for America because. I feel like Americans tend to think that only America exists. It's not even Western culture. It's like America and then everything else.
Okay.
And I'm not saying myself, but I'm saying that's a little exaggerated. But a common attitude you come across is, why do we call the baseball is the American League. Why do we call the end of that the World Series? when it only takes place inside of one country.
Yes,
so
yes, yes.
I don't know. Well, that's interesting. So it's just, but I mean, a lot of the things that you mention in the group are also, yeah, there you go. That's more centered. A lot of the things that you mention in the group are also tied to, for example, English movies or TV shows or, so my question is, how has your curiosity pulled you into that stuff that is more specifically English, like movies and TV shows and stuff that is just in English?
Yes, as respect of the TV shows, I think it's because of the Netflix phenomenon. We are watching TV shows in Netflix or Amazon, and in other time we were watching TV shows on the TV and were produced here in our country.
Right.
Now all the popular TV shows are from the US or the UK.
I feel like it's balanced more so between the US and the UK now. I mean, a lot of the shows that I like on Netflix are from the UK or well, there are more from, for example, Germany, like Dark, which is a German show, which is really good. Okay. So it's more like a availability, but I think a lot of people would still say, let's say someone who wanted to improve their English, it's hard to get into it, and I tend to go back to things in my own language for comfort. So how do you, I mean, when you're watching something, do you watch it only in English? Do you use subtitles? How do you actually take it in?
Yes, now I'm trying to do this. I'm watching with Spanish subtitles, but I try every time to be focused on what they are saying. Mm-hmm. And I try to hear always, and if I don't get what they said, then I read. But it's at the same time. But my focus is on the sound.
Okay. That's interesting. Yeah, when I'm watching a TV show, for example, in Chinese, and I have English subtitles on the screen, I find myself wanting to do what you just described, but then I'm always losing my focus, and I end up just reading the subtitles, and then
yes,
I've sort of lost my purpose in watching it. It's hard to, it's how, hard to stick with it.
How is your level at Chinese?
Oh, I'm a native Chinese speaker, 100%. No, I don't want to get into it. I lived in China for 5 years, so
oh, wow.
I can survive, you know, but there are a lot, it's sort of like domains. There are a lot of areas where if we start talking about one area of words in Chinese, I'm just lost. But if it's something familiar to me, then I'm very comfortable. Do you ever feel that way? In English,
In English, yes, of course, always.
So if we're not talking about philosophy, then you're lost.
No, especially if we are not talking about music. Yes.
Okay. Oh, music.
If I watch a drum lesson, I understand almost 99%.
So what's your background? What's your background? Can you tell me? I have a couple more questions I want to ask you, but what do you do? If you don't mind me asking.
Yes, I am a musician.
I see a guitar back there.
Yes. I play a little bit, but I play drums and percussion, jazz music and ethnic music from South America, that in Latin music also. And I work giving lessons, music lessons, especially drum lessons, but also another kind of lessons like music theory.
That's very cool. So has your industry been affected much by COVID? Do people, are there less music shows?
Yes, you know, since 2 years back from now, I was not playing a lot because I have muscular injuries.
Oh, okay.
And
playing
when
drums
I play,
too hard?
I think, I don't know what is, but really is, or a mental tension that irradiates through my body. And
yeah. Yes. You gotta use crystals, Pablo. Crystals are the answer.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I will try it.
Just put some crystals of different colors around and it'll solve all your problems.
Okay. And crash and
yeah, if you want to. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Crystals. Okay.
Crystals solve all problems. I think. Yeah.
Fine. Yeah. I will Google it.
yeah. I want to ask you about that too. But anyway, yeah. So you were saying about the impact of that of COVID on the industry.
Yes. I was telling you that I was not playing a lot before that, before the pain, the injuries and all that. I was playing and working a lot of gigs and shops, playing drums. But I stopped. And when the COVID came, every musician here have to stop playing, and I feel like good with that. I was not the only one that couldn't work playing. But now they are again getting gigs to play.
Oh, that's cool.
Play.
So more shows happening. Yeah.
Yes. It's more shows. How is that there?
Nothing. Nothing. I can't even go to a restaurant in New York at this point.
Oh.
I can't even go into a restaurant and eat food. I have to take everything out. The only shows that I've seen are drive-in theaters. Do you know what a drive-in theater is? You drive your car there. You drive your car there,
okay,
and you put the
yes.
speaker. And so when the musician is on the stage or the comedian is on the stage, if you like them, instead of clapping, you honk your horn.
I like that.
I think it's very strange, but it's funny. So I don't know if that's going to change soon. But I have a friend who is also a percussionist, who is also a drum instructor and a percussion instructor. It's not you. Another friend who has the same exact. It's very weird. The two people, and he said the exact same thing, except he's still dealing with no shows. So you're in a slightly better situation than he is, I think.
Yes, and why? But in summer in New York, it was not so. you had shows
strict,
and you can
strict, went... not so strict, maybe.
yes, not so strict.
Yeah.
In summer.
Hopefully that will happen this summer. It's not clear. It's not clear. A lot of people are, there's a big thing happening in New York where everybody's leaving the city. A lot of people are just moving because they realize, oh, wait a second. I make a New York salary, but I can do my job at home. So as long as I have an internet connection, I could move to Kansas and buy a house for 10% of the price, and then I would be making way more money. So people are starting to think in this way now,
yes,
I think.
Yes. Incredible.
It's a
yes,
big change.
Yes, here the same.
Yeah.
But not all the people can do their job that way.
Well, for music, yeah, it's different. I would imagine it's different, yeah.
Especially other things, like someone who works on a hospital.
Yeah, it depends on if it's... Because I've had doctor's appointments like this, and they were pretty good. I have one tomorrow. If you have to actually physically get your arms removed or something, then you have to actually go in somewhere. Makes sense. I wanted to ask you a little bit more about... I know that if you are curious about something. So going back to the English stuff.
Yes.
Your curiosity is what drives you. Your curiosity drives you to Wikipedia, which is a great place. It's a wonderful place. What do you have a method? Do you follow a certain method? Do you just click around and read everything? Do you browse sort of casually, or do you have a specific plan or a thing that you follow, or do you just kind of do whatever?
I started entering Wikipedia in English because in Spanish it's not so complete.
Sure.
And because of that, and no, I leave myself free to hypertext.
Yeah, follow links. Yeah.
Follow links freely. Yes, but I'm so curious that I read all the article. I think that is important, maybe.
Do you have a way to remember what you read? Do you have or do you just remember it naturally?
If I am really curious, then I will remember it.
Have you ever played the Wikipedia game, the Six Clicks game? You know that one?
No, I don't know.
Apparently, you within six clicks of any Wikipedia search, you can get to Hitler.
I would try.
That's because it's so many things link. It just makes sense because of the history of it, right? Within six clicks, you can always get to that page.
Very good.
Yeah, it's very interesting. I think I learned that in college. Someone taught me that, and I tried 10 times, and it worked every time. What about, okay, so I have a couple more questions. What about obstacles for yourself, right? Do you actually work on your English in a systematic way? And if so, what things are in your way? What are the most difficult things for you? What things are you trying to overcome right now? And how are you doing that?
I was trying to improve my fluidity, mm-hmm. and I was wanting to speak with somebody and Luke tell me, hey, do a live YouTube live.
And we can do this every week if you want to. That's fine with me. I'm enjoying it.
I love it. No, I think the most difficult to me is this part, to be fluid speaking. I think it's because I have not the possibility to do that in my everyday.
Just actual speaking practice.
Speaking practice, yes, because yeah. To read is easy. You get the book and read. And there are a lot of great lessons also like yours to learn.
You don't have to say that, Pablo, just because I'm here, you know.
It's for real.
Really? Thank you.
It's easy to get that, but to speak with someone is not easy.
So, in other words, knowledge and the background stuff that you need is fine, but the actual usage of it is tough.
Yes, and the listening is new to me. I was practicing this a lot in the last few months, and I will do a very obsessive work with this. I watched all the Lord of the Rings movies.
Oh, classic,
And I will listen. And if I don't get what they said, go back like four or five times until I get that. I don't know if it's good, but I did that.
So your English is improving and your Dwarvish is improving and your Elvish is improving. That's great.
Yeah.
Now you can say Anduin in a very Elvish way. So that's not even a word in English. So that's great. But that's a good choice because there's so much there and it's good, so it wouldn't be boring to watch, to use as practice, right? It's It's an interesting set of movies. It's a great trilogy. Well,
And
on this.
every scene I watch it a lot of times, and it's nice because I am interested on films in every aspect. And when I was trying to catch the phrase, I was watching the lights in this scene or the
Yeah.
costumes.
It's a good choice. I think it's a great choice. Which of the three is your favorite? Fellowship of the Ring, Two Towers, or Return of the King?
The
Fellowship?
first part of the first film.
The
Yes,
narration?
when Gandalf arrives,
Okay.
and I like that feeling. I want to live there.
Wait, so you're saying at the beginning of the trilogy is the highest point and everything else is downhill from there. For the
I
next
don't like the
for the
I don't
next
like the
eight
violence
hours
very
eight
much.
hours and 40 minutes all downhill.
Yes. I don't like the battles very much. I like to live in that fantasy world in the moments that they are relaxed, like on Rivendell.
Or when they're sitting on after the battle of Helm's Deep and the two hobbits, Merry and Pippin are smoking pipes and eating.
Oh yeah,
that's
yeah.
That's the best. That's what I want.
Totally.
I'm gonna start. I'm gonna
want
start
nine
smoking
hours
pipes.
Film. What? Excuse me.
I need to start smoking pipes.
Yes, I want a 9 hours film. Always with that mood.
So it's just Gandalf and hobbits walking around, just smoking and eating and talking.
And fireworks.
You know, you can visit that place in New Zealand. They've made a replica Hobbiton that's complete that you can visit in New Zealand.
Oh, would be great.
You should go. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. I want to go there sometime. That I've heard it's really good. Well, one thing I wanted to recommend, I think I've recommended this before, but just for speaking practice, you might want to check out meetup groups.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
If you're interested, there's one that's going on that is very freestyle and not too difficult, based on an audiobook. So you'd have to listen to the audiobook each week. It's maybe 20 minutes. It's very easy. And then join the discussion. If you're interested, I can send you the link, but it's quite, it would be a good way for you to practice that part, the speaking part.
I like that. I have a friend, native from the US. He was organizing gatherings to play board games in English. It's a good idea.
This is something I want to do on this channel. I want to do have maybe play Code Names or something like that and try that. So we'll have to organize it in the at some point in the WhatsApp group.
Yes, I like that.
That could be interesting. Could end badly. We'll see. So my last question is, what could you recommend? Any specific besides Lord of the Rings? Any TV shows or movies for people who are getting started, who might have something regular that they can watch and practice?
I was watching The Nanny and Seinfeld.
Seinfeld.
I think they're Seinfeld. Yeah, and The Nanny. And I think the sitcoms are great.
What's it called?
Sitcoms.
No, the other one. Seinfeld
The
and...
Nanny. The Nanny. Nanny.
Oh,
Nanny.
The Nanny.
Fran Fine.
I haven't
Fran
seen
Fine,
that.
The Nanny.
Can you do the Seinfeld bass slaps on your bass?
Very good.
Yeah, can you play the bass? Can you play slap bass? Do the intro?
No, not really.
It's tough. Yeah, that I would recommend. I agree with you. There are two shows that came out at the same time, Friends and Seinfeld. Of those two shows, Seinfeld is way better. It's much funnier and smarter and more interesting.
Yes.
So that would be
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah.
Friends I can't believe
little...
you I can't believe you don't know the nanny, the girl who takes care of the kids of Mr. Sheffield.
What is this? 1993, 6 seasons. The nanny. Yeah, I see. Ah,
there is a cultural reference I know and you don't.
Yeah, there you go. I've never even heard of it in my life. What is going on?
Wow.
I recognize her. She talks like she's got a New York accent. She talks like this, right? Is that the one?
She talks like she's from Queens.
Yes. Okay. I think I recognize her.
And very, very voice.
And she's very loud. She's very loud, right? She's always saying her opinion very loudly. Yeah.
I'm very fun. I recommend to you. Okay. It's fun, it's like from the style of the Alf.
Oh yeah, I know Alf.
The extraterrestrial. Yeah. That is famous. Okay.
Let me just make sure I know I've got the right one. I'm pretty sure I know what you're talking about, but I think I can pop this up on the screen quickly. And let's see. Is it this?
Yes. Yes, yes.
Got it. Okay. Oh, she's only in this, isn't she? I've never seen her in anything else.
Yes, I think she was like a model, and then she were married with a TV producer or something like that, and they make this show about how she really is. Like Sanfield, and so like Woody Allen, the comedians that...
She's actually like this. This is her real personality.
Yes, yes.
Okay, I'm definitely going to have to check it out. I can't believe I don't know it. It's pretty insane. And the other one that we're talking about, I'll just put it on the screen, is this one, Seinfeld, which I can strongly, strongly recommend. Can I recommend a TV show to you that's some kind of more obscure?
Yes.
I'm not recommending this to viewers, just to be clear. I'm only recommending this to Pablo specifically. It's a show in the 1960s, and it's called Hogan's Heroes.
Oh, how it is spelled?
Hogans. I'm going to pop it up on the screen. But if you like Seinfeld, it's about prisoners of war in a German prisoner of war camp, and all of the it sounds really dark and serious, but it's a comedy, it's a funny show,
and
it's great. I would strongly recommend this one. I think you'll like it.
Looks funny.
All right, thanks a lot, Pablo. I appreciate it. You have any other things you'd like to add or pieces of advice for viewers?
I don't think so, but all right. Thank you, Luke.
All right, I appreciate
it. It was great. I feel very comfortable.
Yeah, we'll have to do it again. And I like the idea of doing board games as well. So we'll have to try that out in the future. I like the idea of doing like code names or push the button or something like that. What's the one that everyone's playing with the little space guys? What is that one called? You're on a spaceship and you have to figure out who there's someone on the spaceship who's either an alien or someone who shouldn't be on the ship, and you have to figure out who it is and then kick them out.
I never played it.
Among Us, that's what it's called. Maybe we'll have to try that.
Okay. And there is a board game named Pandemic. You knew that?
I've heard of that. Do you know if they have a digital version?
I don't know, but I was playing it, and a few months before the pandemic arrived.
Maybe yes. not very tasteful at the moment to play that one.
No, but it was great.
Yeah.
Very similar.
Yeah. All right. Well, I think we can call it a day. I know you've got something coming up, Pablo, but I just want to read one comment. Someone in the comments named Casper said, he's absolutely French. So there you go.
Because of my looks.
The Frenchman. All right, Pablo, thanks a lot, and we'll talk on the backside. I'll talk to you later. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Luke. Goodbye.
See ya. All right. That was fun. That was good. I hope I didn't miss any questions specifically for Pablo. I saw the comment that he's French, which is, I think, quite funny. There is something French about Pablo. I agree with that. He's not French, but something French about him. Aleida says, I'm an Argentinian too. I'd like to take part in the chat group. Is it possible? Maybe we could do a group chat at some point in the future. I'd have to think about how we'd put it together. But yeah, I mean, I like the idea of doing it, definitely. Do all foundation students finish at 3 p.m.? Finishes. If I would say this queue, I'll choose finish because all students. Yes, that's right. Finish. All students finish at 3 p.m. Ted Lasso. Okay, I have to check that one out. Ted Lasso. Great. Yes, Tavo, it's called Hogan's Heroes. One of my favorite shows. Is hilarious. Hogan's Heroes. But not a very well-known show, actually. Most people don't know it. Patricio says, we have our own version of the nanny in Argentina, but the American is better. Interesting. The nanny. I don't know why I've never seen it. It's weird. I'm very curious to check out the nanny. Do you guys mind if I, just because I'm curious what the heck the nanny is and why I've never heard of it. Let me check it out. We can watch a clip of it together. Try not to get a copyright strike. Let's see. Let's see. Hold on a second. Let me open up my browser. Cloud English is live. That's good news. Okay. First pilot episode. Hold on. I'm just checking this really quickly. Fran dates Tony the Monster. What? All right, we'll just check a quick clip of this because I'm just curious. I'm just curious.
Pay for what you need.
Hey everyone, welcome to Forward.
Just an
we
ad.
We have a new kind of doctor's office.
All right, all right.
Primary care differently.
That's fine.
Oh, Miss Fine, look at you. Don't you look ravishing?
Thanks. I'm going out with Tony tonight.
Oh wait, I gotta fix my. Where's my pip? I gotta fix my pip. Hold on. Half of my face is covering the screen. Don't want that. Let me make myself smaller. Is that better? There we go. All right.
That?
Don't you like it?
Well, it's just that it's freezing outside.
What? Crude humor. Unbelievable.
Did you enjoy the show?
Good show. Yeah. The teapot was funny.
So.
Oh, I remember that laugh. I think I must have seen an episode of this at some point.
What do you like to do besides dress like a million bucks and drive around in a limo? Which is all I ever really aspire to.
That's definitely a New York accent. If you want to know how the sort of classic New York accent sounds, that's it right there.
Would you excuse me, please? I've got to go powder my nose. You got to go, too? Boy, this is getting freaky.
Well, because he's a mobster.
Oh, God.
Interesting. I'll have to check it out. Good suggestion from Pa. Pablo. Ooh, maybe I should show disposable cameras. I remember those. The Nanny was on TV in Mexico for 2 years. Okay. We also made our own version of Married with Children, and it was actually very successful. Cool. Let's see. Hogan's Heroes. Yeah, here we go. This is Hogan's Heroes. So I'm going to show a short clip. This is the probably the funniest character is Schultz. He's one of the prison guards. He always comes in. He's always very angry. Let me skip to Schultz here.
I can't just in the f***ing day here.
I know when I hear something.
All right, Schultz, let's try to help you. What was it you heard?
It was like, boom, boom.
Boom, boom. Was it like this?
No, it was like, boom, boom.
Or was it this?
Boom, boom.
Stop it.
He's a very, very silly character, but he's only one of the many funny characters. This show was produced in the late 60s, I believe. When was it produced? I'm not quite sure. I think it was in the 60s, but anyway, it's a good show. Definitely worth checking out. Okay. Thanks again to Pablo for the interview. Hey, Pablo's in the chat. Now the drum makes sense to me. Now I get it. Now I understand. Cool guy. Hey, bro, you don't have to know everything. You got this. Oh, all right. Well, now I know. Now I know I don't have to know everything. Good to know. How about speaking sessions on Zoom and broadcast it on YouTube? That's an interesting idea. That's an interesting idea. Let's see. Vissel. So Vissel says she was dead. She died. These two have the same exact meaning? No, but it's an interesting question, and I'm glad that you mentioned it. So what does it mean to say that she died? I'm not laughing because she died. It's not even a real person. It's a fictional person. I can laugh, right? I'm not laughing because of that. I'm laughing because of what the first one would mean. So she died. Died is a thing that happens, and then once that happens, you are dead. So the state is being dead. I couldn't say I'm dead, but if you were somehow, if you watched the movie, what's that movie about? Coco? Yeah, Coco. Well, then they could say, I am dead, because that's happening in the afterlife, that movie, right? So they can say that. Well, what is that? That's a state or a condition. It's like saying, I'm hungry. I'm angry. It's a state or a condition. But dying is not a state or a condition, right? Jumping is an action, a thing that happens. Once you jump, then you could say, I am in the air for a short period of time, right? I'm in the air. But the jump is the momentary action. It's an action verb, okay? So that's what this one is. Number two would be, I think, the one you would want to use. She died. Now, that's not necessarily the most polite way to say it, but that's correct. Now, what about the other one? She was dead. Is that different? How is it different? Yes, it's different, but what is the difference? To say she was dead means that she, in the past, was in that condition or that state of being dead. Just like when I jump, I am in the state of being in the air, right? I'm in the air, but that ends pretty fast. When I land on the ground, I am not in the air anymore. So if somehow she died and then she came back from the dead. Either she's a zombie, although technically that would not be not dead because zombies are dead, or somehow She was declared dead, brain dead, and then somehow came back or something like that. The only time when you would actually hear this would be something like, she was declared dead at 8:59, and then 3 minutes later, she recovered or she revived. That would be when the official announcement is this person has died because their brain functions have stopped and their heart has stopped. But it happens sometimes that you can be dead technically, but then you come back for whatever reason. They use those electrodes on you, those paddles, they use that, or maybe they put some smelling salts under your nose, or they slap you around, or whatever they have to do. It happens, right? So someone says then later, I was legally dead. I was brain dead. I was pronounced dead. I was legally dead for 2 minutes, and then they brought me back using a few hard slaps across the face. And then I came back. Now you could say, well, that's not really dead, is it? I don't know. But that's what people would mean when they say it. She was dead. Okay, so actually they're very different in meaning. But it's a good question, though. Thank you very much for the question, Vissel, as usual. Guys, if you haven't already, don't forget to hit the like button, please. Thank you. Also subscribe and check out my full courses in the links in the description. Okay. Good question from Vissel, as usual. Always good questions from Vissel. Why do I have these in my ears? Hey, Luke, question. What exactly means the phrase, I dig it? I don't understand completely when it appears. Oh, that's a good question, too. Lots of good questions. Lots of good questions. Okay, pop that one up. I never have understand what is the meaning in the end of the sentence. Which sentence are you talking about, Mert? Which sentence do you mean? Patricio says, hey, Luke, question. What exactly does the phrase I dig it mean? I don't understand it completely when it appears. Okay. When someone says, I dig it, is this talking about digging a hole? Someone talking about scooping something? What are we talking about? No. If someone says, I dig it, it means I'm into that. It means I like that. It means I think that's cool. It means I think that's interesting. I use this fairly often, actually. When someone says something and I like it in general, I can say, yeah, I dig it. What kind of thing? Almost anything. Now, usually when I say it, it's for a plan that someone has or something someone has thought of that I think is interesting. What if we try this? Yeah, we could try that. I dig it. Or I was thinking we could go to the park and do some LARPing this afternoon. Yeah, sounds good. I dig it. Let's LARP. If you don't know what LARPing is, that's okay. But it's a thing that you could do in the park. Right? So I would say, I dig it. Now, if I want to talk about just things I like, then I could say, yeah, I dig philosophy. I dig it. That would be fine. That would be totally acceptable. Now, I think this is more often said by the generation above me, which would be what we would call boomers. My father's generation kind of came out of the late 60s, 70s. This phrase, I think, started to become popular. Can you dig it? Means, are you into it? Right? A lot of people use it to mean I'm into something. I really dig LARPing. I love LARPing. I really dig LARPing. I'm into LARPing. All right? So you like that. That's fun for you. You think that's interesting. Okay? That's all it means. Can you use it in the negative? I don't dig it. Do you dig it? No, I do not dig it. If someone asks you directly, do you dig it? Then you could answer, not really. But we would not say, I don't dig it as a positive statement. I don't dig this. We would tend to say, I don't really like it. Not a big fan. Not really into that. So. So that's much more common. So yes, it's a common phrase, but always be aware when you learn a new phrase, who's using it? There are generational differences. The usage of language is different from group to group. Pay attention to that sort of thing, but also don't be afraid to use it. I use it maybe 3 times a week, something like that. All right, good question, Patricio. I hope I'm saying your name correctly. Guys, if you haven't already, don't forget to like. That helps the channel out a lot. Subscribe if you want to see future videos. And check out my full courses on sale in the links in the description. Okay. Kareem says, hey, Luke, how are you doing? I'm doing well, Kareem. Thank you. Appreciate that. I do have a bit of sniffling going on, though. What does though mean? That's at the end of the sentence. Oh, actually, it's short for T-H-O-U-G-H. T-H-O-U-G-H, though. I don't know, though. I did a whole video about the word though. I would recommend that you check that out. I mean, I could try to answer the question now, but I feel like the complete answer is in a previous video I posted on the channel, and that would give you the biggest possible picture of the usage of the word though, and including though at the end of the sentence, which is what you're talking about. And all you have to do is, I mentioned it as T-H-O-U-G-H, just replace that in your mind with T-H-O. Not a correct spelling, but a common abbreviation. Common abbreviation. All right. If you guys noticed, but I'm using a new camera now. Is it obvious, or does it look the same? I think the colors are a little bit better, a little more natural. Got some nice autofocus going on, right? That's nice. Quite excited about it. Would you make a video about jokes and stand-up comedy shows in English and how to understand it? That's actually a good idea. I'm going to add that to a list. Maybe I can talk about that later this week next week. Stand-up jokes. Yeah, that's actually a great idea, Kareem. Thank you for that suggestion there. This is a good one. I can't answer it sort of on the spot, though. It's something I would have to kind of prepare for. You know what I mean? I got to prepare. Write that down. Thank you, Kareem. Yeah, if someone could send a link to the video, the though video, that would be great. I think I posted about 4 months ago, maybe? About 4 months ago. All right. Got any other questions? Did I miss any questions? Did I miss any questions? My coffee's cold. That's how I know how much time has passed. All right, guys. Well, in that case, I think we'll call it a day. Hey, Amber's here. Hello, Amber. Just to say hello. Hello, Amber. Amber and I used to work together. We used to be colleagues. And that was fun. All right, guys, I think it's time for me to go have some lunch. I think that's what time it is. I'm pretty sure. But again, thanks to Pablo for doing the interview. I appreciate Pablo. I don't know if Pablo's in the chat, but thank you very much, Pablo. A million Luke points to you, sir. Thanks for the great questions today. I appreciate that. I'll be back. I'm planning to do another live stream tomorrow. So check back tomorrow. I'll try to start a little earlier. Get your questions ready. If you have English questions, culture questions, whatever it may be. And otherwise, I hope you have a great day, a great evening, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Also, if you have ideas for the Zoom call thing, I think it would be interesting, but Let me know what you think. Give me your ideas. Guys, don't forget to, of course, also hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Very important. Like, subscribe, follow, and check out the full courses in the links in the description. See you guys in the next one. Yeah, Pablo, pop in the link to the group. You want to do that? Bye, Amber. Thanks for popping in to say hi. Hope you're doing good. Hope you're doing well. Hopefully someone can pop in the link to the WhatsApp group if you guys want to join. If not, well, I don't know what to say. I'm just a dude in there. So, all right, guys. See you next time. Bye.